Hi everyone, it's Yanis here, and in this video, we will explore what is top-down processing and how does it work. I'll be also sharing some examples of top-down processing so that it is easier to understand it. If this is your first time on this channel, then make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon to get updates on my latest videos about time management and productivity. Top-down processing refers to perception that is driven by cognition. Your brain applies what it knows and what it expects to perceive and fills in the blanks. When we utilize top-down processing, our ability to understand information is influenced by the context in which it appears. If I show you this element and ask you what do you think it is, then you would probably say that these are some random lines. But if I add these two letters, now suddenly the random lines start to look like a letter H. Now let's remove them and add these two letters. Situation again changes and random lines start to look like an A. Top-down processing is the process of using the context and general knowledge to understand what we actually perceive. So as you can see, the context is what determines the meaning, and that is how top-down processing works. Top-down processing serves a positive function by simplifying the way we consume the information. Part of the reason is that top-down processing helps us to recognize patterns. Patterns are useful because they help us to understand and know how to interact with the world. On the other side, by using top-down processing, we're getting used to things, and that can limit us in a certain ways. You might get stuck with the simple things, like copying text on the computer. This happened to me after I switched from a Windows laptop to my MacBook. I hope that you enjoyed this video and I was able to give you a quick overview about top-down processing and how it actually works. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button. And if you're new to this channel, then type new in the comments below.